in contact pair problems, when two surfaces forms a contact pair, then how to decide which is the contact and target surface, or which is the master and slave surface? So in this video we will going to discuss about the guidelines in order to decide which one is the contact or which one is the target surface. So let's discuss first about the contact definition. So when two separate surfaces touch each other such that they become mutually tangent, then we can say that they are said to be in a contact. In general, the master surface forms on touching body or on the body on which other moving surface will come in contact, and the slave surface forms on the touching body, or in present case the body which is moving downward to form a contact. There are few other guidelines which are used to decide which one is slave and which one is master surface. We'll discuss in next slide. Now let's discuss about the guidelines for contact surfaces. As we know that when there is a contact formation develop, then there is two major types of behavior. The first one is asymmetric behavior. So in case of asymmetric behavior, only the contact surfaces are constrained from penetrating the target surfaces. Now the other behavior is nothing but the symmetric behavior. In this case, the contact surfaces are constrained from penetrating the target surfaces and vice versa. So these guidelines are basically useful in case of asymmetric behavior, but you can also use when there is a both kinds of behavior, like symmetric as well as asymmetric behavior between the contacts. Now let's discuss about the first guideline, which says that if one surface has a coarse mesh and the another contacting surface have the fine mesh, then in that case the target surface should be the surface with the coarse mesh, you can see, and the fine surface should be the slave surface. Now let's discuss the other guideline, which says that if one surface is having higher order elements, so you can see like midside nodes are present, and the another surface which is the contacting surface having lower order elements, so in such a scenario the target surface should be with the lower order surface. Okay, so you can say that when higher order as well as lower order surfaces are come in contact, then the higher order surface is nothing but slave or contact, and the lower order surface is nothing but the master or target surface. Now let's discuss about the another guideline, which says that when one surface is steeper than the other, for example here in this case the pulley which is having the higher steepness which forms the contact with the belt which is having the less steepness, so in such a scenario you can say that the steeper surface should be the target surface. Okay, now let's discuss about the another guideline, which says that if one surface is larger than the other surface, You can say, for example, this is nothing but the larger surface which comes in contact with the smaller surface, then in such a scenario, the largest surface should be the target surface.